All right, well, it may be cold outside, but that doesn't mean that you can't check out the farmers markets. They're still going on, and there's one in Concord. It's located at the Cole Gardens in Concord. And Carole is from the Miles Smith Farm, and you raise.
We raise Scottish Highlanders and Angus cattle. We raise them naturally without hormones and antibiotics, and we sell them in packages like this so the public can enjoy our product.
So you are there at the Concord Farmers Market
Yes.
in the winter, and we should also let people know that this takes place in a greenhouse, so it's warm. You're not outside,
exactly.
And there's music and face painting, so it's a really good family-friendly event. Lots of vegetables there, which
Yes.
you also brought.
Yes. Now, every vegetable here is for sale at the farmers market, at the Concord Farmers Market. And today we're going to show you how to use the vegetables to make a delicious beef stew. I've put garlic oil in this pan, and I'm adding some onions. Then I'm going to add 2 pounds of ground beef. Now, you may notice that this pot is a little bit different. It's a pressure cooker. Now, remember what we used to think about pressure cookers? That they would explode?
Right.
But they don't. Today's pressure cookers are really safe. In fact, Bobby Flay used one last night on Cook's Corner.
I know, they do use it quite often now on the Food Network, I know.
So they're wonderfully safe. So what you do is you start out by braising the onions and the oil and the chopped stew meat. You put it in the pressure cooker. You brown it. And then when it's brown, you add 2.5 cups of water. And I'm going to kind of speed the process.
Right.
So you add 2.5 cups of water. And then you put your pressure cooker top on. And this is a great tool. You put it on, if you can get it right, you push this little thing up, you make sure that's forward, and as soon as that little yellow dot comes up, it's at pressure. It's that simple.
Right.
And they're very safe and very easy.
And it cooks quicker.
It cooks quicker. 15 minutes to do your meat this way. Normally it would be an hour or an hour and a half because stew beef really has to cook a long time.
Mm-hmm.
And after I've worked feeding my 85 head of cattle, I don't have a lot of time. And I don't often plan ahead for my meals. So when I come in at 7 or 8 at night, I want to have a delicious beef stew. This is the best thing for me.
And now you have carrots and some potatoes. And what else do
These
you have
are
here?
Turnips. Now, I've used turnips. These are the turnips I used from the vegetable ranch. You could also use parsnips. You could use garlic. You could use broccoli. You can use any of the squash. So those are the four vegetables that I've chosen, onions, carrots, and these carrots. Don't taste anything like you get at the supermarket. They are a different flavor. They're sweet. They are delicious.
Right.
They may not look perfect, but they're delicious.
And Carole, we're kind of running out of time here, but how long do you cook that?
Goes for 15 minutes.
Okay.
When it's done, I've pre-cooked some. So the first thing I'm going to do is add my roux, which is a little, this thickens. This gives you the gravy. It's a little cornstarch and flour in water that I've already put together. Mm-hmm. I mix that in. Then I just put all my vegetables in. Carrots, turnips, and these are Yukon Gold potatoes. Mm-hmm. They're also known as Carola.
All right.
So put those in.
Unfortunately, we're running out of time, Carole, but we will try and get this on our website, and we do want to let you know again about the farmer's market that goes on in Concord. You can get more information. It goes on Saturdays, and find more information at ConcordWinterFarmersMarket.com, and there are other farmer's markets throughout the winter, other places, so you can just go online and find out information.
And buy local. Buy often and local.
All right, Carole, thank you so much.
Thank
we appreciate
you,
it. Again, from Miles
Smith Farm.
There we go, and we'll be right back.